Fuck. Looking for the girl with the biggest nuts. Why always let me break your back? Looking for the girl with the biggest nuts. Why always let me break your back? Looking for the girl with the biggest nuts. Why always let me break your back? Looking for the girl with the biggest.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Wacky Temple back again with a brand new video for me. Today I got you with a cool little story time. My first heartbreak. You were my first heartbreak, you feel me? You didn't think pretty niggas like me could be heartbroken, but it happened. And it was like 15-16 class, you feel me? So let's get right into this video. Bow. Alright, so basically this happened in 15-16 class in primary school, you feel me? where I wasn't the person I am today, you heard it, you feel me? So basically, I wasn't really into making friends and all that shit, yeah, you feel me? And then basically, in four class is when I really decided to like make friends. So this whole thing kicked off in like four class, but that was when I started having a crush on this girl, you feel me? Yeah, you know when you go up a level, then they usually shuffle you to make new friends, mix up your class and all that, basically. So that's what happened. And then they mixed up our classes and left like a few people from my second class into my third class. So I was like cool. That was cool with them, you feel me? So that whole year I chilled with them, the same people from my second class. I didn't really want to make new friends because back then I wasn't really a social type person, you feel me? I was more like a conservative person. I like to chill with people I knew, my business, you feel me? I wasn't trying to make new friends, talk to anyone. And I was a shy kid back in the day. If you knew me back in the day, like a couple of my boys know me from back in the day, they know I was a shy person, quiet person, not the person I am today, basically. So I didn't really make friends. I probably made one or two friends, and those were guys even. And then it was probably like five people that I chilled with throughout that whole year of school. So then basically four class came around, and then me and this girl became friends, right? And then it was a thing where we were friends, but we still kind of chill with our own group separately, you feel me? And it wasn't really a thing where I go over to her and start talking to her, like random conversation type shit, because I still had that shyness in me, you feel me? But like obviously she didn't come over and talk to me either, so I feel like it's just a thing that everyone had going on back in the day, where everyone just chilled with the people they knew and the people that they were friends with from the jump, you feel me? But somehow anyway, me and that girl became friends. So basically, so far in four class, me and her became friends, right? And cool, everything was calm before class. Fifth class, it was like I started having a crush on her. It was towards the end of the year, even not even towards the start of the year, the middle of the year, you feel me? So I started having a crush on her, but I didn't move to her, I didn't say anything to her because I was shy, like I was an antisocial kid back in the day, you feel me? And then so that's in fifth class. Sixth class came along. I was like, obviously sixth class, that was when everyone felt, oh, you felt big, you felt up there, you feel me? Obviously I was feeling a bit up there, still not out of my shell, but still felt slightly confidence. You feel me? So it was like So this is when I feel like it was time for me to make my move, make my mark, take the step. I was like, this is the final countdown. Feel me? I was like, all right, bet. It's your boy, YK Temple. Obviously, I wasn't YK Temple back in the day. I was just Temple, not even capital T, small T. You feel me? And then, I wanted to make my move. So basically, Valentine's Day came along, right? And I thought to myself, this is the perfect chance for me to shoot my shot. For me to, you feel me? I was like, all right, bet. Now's your time to shine, Temple. Now's your time to shine. Cool. So basically what I done was I wrote a crush letter and I like you letter for her. But guys, let me tell you how I wrote this shit. I wrote it, right? And obviously I didn't hand it to her straight because I was shy. I wrote it, and then you know when it's like a break, lunchtime, or not even lunchtime is where you go outside, when there's a break time and everyone goes to their group, the teacher leaves the room, the girls go to the girls group where their friends are, the boys go to the boys group where their friends are. Basically there's a break, everyone went to their groups, the teacher left the class. And before I went to my group, I had the letter pre-written, or I wrote on the spot, one or the other. And I had it in my hand, right? When she went to her group, I think my table's across from her, something like that. I snuck and put it in like her journal or something. You feel me? And I went back to my boys' group to talk to them. Like, nothing happened, none of them seen it. But back in the day, the boys knew already that I kinda had a crush on her. But it was like, it was a thing where everyone had crushes back in the day. No one cared, you feel me? So I put in her thing in a little copy or whatever. And yeah, cool, we were all chilling, talking. Lunchtime ended, teacher came back in. But before teacher came back in, everyone actually got back to their seats, you feel me? The girl got back to her seat with her girls group or whatever. She opened her copy. The copy that I put the letter in, right? Like, this was, when I put this in, this was meant for her to just open it on her way home or something and be like, oh my gosh, Temple's so cute type shit. Or not even Temple, because it was anonymous, you feel me? But it was something I should put to open in her walls, you feel me? Not with the girls, just by herself, you feel me? Just so she can inhale it and down it, you feel me? But she took it back and opened it with her friends or whatever. And you know what girls do, they tell their friends whatever they're feeling, back in the day especially. And then it was like, she told her friends. And then, because it was anonymous, they also tried to guess who it was. Because the girls didn't really know I had a crush on her. But most of the boys knew. I don't know how, because it's only like one or two people I told, but you feel me, it spreads. Obviously, yeah, the girls knew, whatever. It was a love letter. She opened it, read it in front of her friends or whatever. She didn't read out loud, I was thinking, or she probably passed it around type shit. But yeah, she read it. She opened it up, read it. Cool. Teacher got back, then suddenly, when teacher got back and class was calm and everything, people were asking me, was it you that wrote the love letter? Or the crush letter to her? Was it you? Then people were assuming that was me. People were asking me, then there's people that were assuming it was me, you feel me? So obviously, people that assumed me were like the people that had an idea, because they probably found out because of other people, you feel me? And people that asked me were people like the girls that were friends with her. Also, she kind of knew that I had something on for her, you feel me? Like a slight crush on her. She kind of knew. I don't know how she knew either. So basically, later that year, obviously after she saw the letter, she didn't say anything to me. Like, because she wasn't 100% sure. She wouldn't just want to come over to me and be like, oh, you wrote this letter? Oh, type shit. You feel me? So obviously, later that year, I was feeling a bit more up there, full of myself type shit. It was just because I was in sixth class and I was like, it was the end of the year type shit. And obviously you only get shit out of your chest and move forward. You don't carry this weight on your shoulder, especially like when you're that young and crushes are a big deal, you feel me? So obviously I was like, let me make my move. Let me shoot my shot. Let me take my chances. What's the worst that could happen, right? So obviously she can say yes. Obviously she can say no. Obviously she can say she was feeling me. Obviously she can say she wasn't, you feel me? It's one or the other. Not too complicated, you feel me? Yeah, right, cool. So I went up to her and I was like, I told her I liked her, but I done it in a way where I done it in a way where her friends were like with her. Her friends were near her, like type shit. So it was like I went up to her, but she wasn't really sure there, because say the girl in the group, right? She was like point outside of the group, walking towards the group, whatever. So I went over to her and I told her. I think I said in a very like blank way, like just I like you type shit, you feel me? Very, very simpy, moisty, yeah, type way, you feel me? Basically, I told her. Then she didn't say back or any of that. So I was like, oh, maybe she's just tired. Maybe she's just sleepy, you feel me? Because she didn't say back or whatever. Went over to her friends, told her friends. But I was like, I was still beside the group or beside her. Told her friends, had laughed and all that. And I was like, I just walked away. I walked away in disgust. I was like, how could you do this type shit, you feel me? And then I just walked away. So yeah, I told her again, right? And then, woo! This time I told her, but she was one of the guys, you feel me? One of the guys that were, what's it called? I was friends with, but like, friends, do you feel me? Like, everyone used that word friends. That's what was back in the day. So basically, I was friends with him. And I saw her way and welcomed her. So I just thought they were just friends. It was cool. I thought everything was fine with them. I didn't think they had shit going on between both of them. Little did I know. I went over to her. I told her I liked her again, you feel me? Because I thought this was my time. Like, because she looked energetic at the time. Or like last time, where I thought she was sleepy. You feel me? So basically, I told her. And then it was like, then she ran away from me, guys. And she ran away, and I was just there in my shower, like, don't run away from the truth, cause I'm not giving up on you, type shit, you.
Baby, I'ma make you mine, and I ain't giving up, don't run away from the truth, cause I'm not giving up on you.
And then she was like, yeah, she got to get whatever. And I think the boy that was with her, he just walked off or some shit like that. Or he went towards her. But she didn't, like, she ran. I don't know why she ran away. Like, I wasn't scary. And then, she ran away. And then basically after that, someone else came over to me and told me that the guy that she was with and the girl, they were together. And I was devastated. I was like, I'm Mr. Lonely. You feel me? Bishop, you're not getting into it. But basically, yeah, I was like, I'm Mr. Lonely. And then it's like, Bishop, stop looking at me. But I found out they were together. And I was obviously devastated. I was like, damn, how did my dog do this to me? You feel me? I thought it was meant to be cool. Rose before. Females, you feel me? And I was like, oh yeah, alright. At the end of that year, I was just like, I moved on because there's nothing I could do, you feel me? But yeah, that's that. She left me for my boy. And obviously, I was devastated. But yeah, guys, I don't recommend these females. Don't recommend. Nah, I'm joking. But anyways, that's that, you feel me? That's that. Basically, guys, that's the end of this video. If you want more story times, let me know. Make sure you leave a like, a comment, and subscription. Subscription is important for me. Help me get up, improve my sport industry. You feel me? Let's go up together. Turn on the post notifications as well, so you don't miss out when I post, and you'll be the first to watch and first to comment. You feel me? Soon I'll start doing giveaways, so keep in touch with all of that. You feel me? I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.
Came up with some pack, I got that shit pushing, I got that shit off in the same day. I thought it was real, but bitch be playing, so I'ma just focus and get paid. Came up with some pack, I got that shit pushing, I got that shit off in the same day.